Is your boss a bully, or maybe that coworker sitting in the cubicle right next to yours? They shout, they scream, they humiliate, they try to intimidate you just for kicks a lot of the times. Well, most victims have to suffer in silence, but some fight back. This is the subject of tonight's Fact Finders Report. Here is Peter Thorne.
All right, Jim. Grown men and women being bullied at work. So many victims, but few speak out, often fearing for their jobs. Tonight, pulling back the curtain on workplace bullies and where to find help if you're the victim.
Hello, I'm Emelisa Aleandri.
New Yorker Emelisa Aleandri has hosted a TV show. She's written books, including these two.
And you ain't paid your rent in 2 months. Fuck yes, huh?
See, you said on me.
She's had acting roles in movies like Spike Lee's Crooklyn.
No mas, no mas.
But Emelisa Aleandri was crying no mas for real after surviving a disturbing workplace drama, a harrowing ordeal that took place far off screen, facing harassment from a bully at work.
The more you did, the better you were, the more of a threat you were, and the more he wanted you out of the picture.
She says her supervisor was not just demanding, but demeaning and determined to make her quit.
Things like breaking into your office when you're away, being watched, having people report on you, giving my work to an intern that I trained, not giving me my mail, not giving me my phone messages.
Aleandri claims she suffered years of such retaliation after filing a discrimination complaint.
I've only given you the tip of the iceberg of the daily harassment that went on.
Aleandri fought back, sued, and wound up sharing a seven-figure settlement. Her fight is a battle many American workers face, happening at work every day, a phenomenon called workplace bullying, gaining new attention as more victims come forward to tell their stories of intolerable treatment at work.
It was sitting right across from a woman who would harass me nonstop all day long. I really, you know, I could hardly get anything done.
We spoke to Professor Gary Namie, who wrote this book and runs the Workplace Bullying and Trauma Institute. He describes four kinds of workplace bullies. Have you met this one? What he calls the screaming meme.
The fist-pounding, vein-bulging maniac who prefers a public arena. Their goal is to instill fear in the target, and they want to paralyze all the coworkers. They want to make sure the coworkers understand that F-word, fear.
He warns workplace bullying can hurt your health.
Strange as it sounds, it's usually your family physician who catches it, saying, "Why in the world are you back in for that fourth cold in a couple months? What is going on with that skyrocketing blood pressure? Your health impact is what's going to give it away."
Right now, activists pushing for new legislation because there aren't a lot of laws that cover this problem. If you're being bullied at work and don't know where to turn, you might want to turn to the Workplace Bullying Institute. For a link to their website, go to WB11.com. So it can be pretty awful in some offices.
Try your best not to be a target.
You can, of course, stand up for yourself and say you're not going to take it. But some people, of course, when they do that, they're in fear for their job.
Sure.
So it's hard to know where to turn.
Definitely.
Exactly. And now there's a place called Workplace Bullying Institute.
That's right.
Wow. Who knew? Okay.